Moving on to Star Wars now. We are going with the prototype armor for Boba Fett. This was in the old black and white. Joe Johnson designed the armor for the infamous bounty hunter, and there is a lot of new tooling on him because he's not dented. We also changed the way the armor attaches to the vest. It's different than our previous Boba Fett release where it's pinned. This one is Velcro attached, so you can kind of place it a little better in the vest how you want to show it. He has gauntlet attachments that are new, two new guns, a new backpack with a grappling hook. The fins on the rocket extend out and it's manually, you can friction fit it in or out and launch it if you want. There's not a spring release, but it's just a manual rocket tip. He has new spats, new cut and sew, new belt, and he's got a version of the cape with a gray stripe, and he also has the beach towel cape, so you'll get both versions on him. I believe the beach towel is the exclusive. Next up is a Clone Trooper Deluxe. We have four versions of him. We have a veteran, we have a shiny, we have a 501st, and we have a 212, which is a retail special. Both of these are going to have brand new helmets that were sculpted. The Phase 2 and the Phase 1 will both be brand new. They'll have their reverse lenses, so we'll have a little more depth to them. They're a lot more screen accurate, totally different than the previous ones. So they'll have new shoulder bells, which aren't on here, but we have it in the final product, so it'll give them a little more beefiness. The armor is also going to be a snap release rather than glued, so if people have an issue and we need to send a replacement instead of the whole figure, we can just send you the armor pieces, so an easy swap out if anything arises, and also allows the customer to customize it if they so choose, because now they can snap release the armor. They also will come with a Gatling cannon, the new backpack, some grenades, a new long rifle with a harpoon attachment that can slide on or off depending if you want the cartoon version or if you want the movie version. Coming up next is Commander Wolf. This presentation of Wolf shows the factory paint on the portrait, and this is, again, is a brand new portrait. It's going to have a separate faceplate, separate hair, and separate eyes. So there's multiple components within the portrait. So we're going to cast the eyes in a glossy, clear, tinted ABS. The hair and the portrait are a PVC, and what the purpose of this is to allow for the people making it to be able to paint it better. Get the skin tones of the parts are separate, then when they finally assemble it, it'll be more of a better presentation of the portrait. That's our hope. So we're looking forward to Wolf coming out. Wolf will also have two new helmets, the new Phase 1 helmet, as well as his episode or Phase 3 custom helmet that he has, which is on the floor next to him. Right next to Wolf is Malgus. This Malgus right here is complete product. This is from our first sample from our factory. Everything on there is all factory done, so we're pretty excited about how well he came out and how good of a job they've done. It's a pretty heavy figure, it's a pretty massive figure. So we are pretty happy with how he came out, so we wanted to show everyone what the product will look like. Next to them is the two-pack security battle droids. These are the same droids we offered prior with and the Brown Infantry, but they have a different deco. And we obviously unveiled them to support their guy, General Grievous. This is our final version of General Grievous. This is all the factory version, all the joints. We showed Grievous 2 years ago, and a lot of people have been asking, and we showed him at the time to show proof of life that we were working on him. We had him done. We had him painted for the proto. Since then, the reason for the delay is we've modified and got the joints as tight as we possibly can so they have nice ratchet. Did some little engineering changes. We've added some guts into his chest cavity. We've gone through a couple of different paint schemes, so a lot of people have been asking, why does he look different than the one we showed 2 years ago? Well, that was a completely different piece and was painted for the show. We've painted a couple more times over to try to get the paint right so that the factory could replicate the marble look of the armor. And it's a little hard to see behind the glass, but there is a lot of depth in the armor with some to show the marbling. And I'm quite proud of how it turned out. So for everyone asking why does he look different than the previous viewing at Comic-Con, is it's just a different paint scheme that we use for the final product. So Grievous right now will have two portraits. The faceplate removes. The exclusive is a battle damaged one, so he'll have a blast mark on his left eye. He'll also have a staff with a removable electricity energy ends that can slide on or off the caps. We'll have four lit lightsabers, four unlit lightsabers that will fit in the pockets in the cape. We'll have a brand new base to support him that has on a rotating base stem so that you can support him how you want. And this is General Grievous, and hoping that we can get into production soon and have him out to customers by the end of the year, if not sooner. Jumping over to our Hoth display, we have a couple new products in here, as well as one we showed last year. Last year we showed Darth Vader. Happy to say that what you're seeing here is a majority of the parts are from our factory. The suit, the cape, the skirt, undergarment, the bodysuit, boots, hands, everything, the chest box, the codpiece, the helmet, and the mantle are outputs from our digital file. We did some slight modifications to the helmet from last year, the one that was presented last year, so the helmet is slightly different. It's slightly different than the gallery we showed, but we will be updating our gallery soon so that everyone can see a little bit better detail, the changes, slight modifications to the helmet. The chest box and the belt boxes will both light up. There will be sequencing red lights on the chest box, and the green lights on the belt boxes will light up. There's a small little battery pack on the back of him that people can just switch on or off as they like. Vader, what's not shown with Vader is a giant illuminated display base with glowing red lights on it that has the Imperial symbol. He also has a display base that illuminates for his mask. He also has another portrait that has the old Anakin reveal, so you can display him either with the helmet portrait or with a half portrait, which has partial exposure of the Anakin face. Darth Vader is here, and we're happy to share what people should hopefully expect on the final product. Moving on next, we have our probe droid. This is our kind of caught some people off guard. Probe droid will be done completely in hard plastic, so all the detail will be there. Arms are all articulate. He'll have a light. The cannon slightly articulates. The antennas will slide up and down. He'll have a support rod base, and the base, he'll also come with a cap that's a sculpted ice piece that you can slide up and over the base if you want to create a diorama setting, or if you just want to appreciate it as a maquette. You can have a nice clean base without the ice on there, so it's up to the customer's discretion what they'd like. Coming up next is our version of Echo Base Han. We have some of the accessories displayed with him. He'll also have some other stuff that's not shown. They'll have an array of hands, boots, parka. We'll have two portraits, one with the hat, one without the hat. Some other pieces that are still getting finished up, but this is Han Solo. On top of the Tauntaun is Luke. Luke will have a couple portraits as well. All new cut and sew, array of hands as well. And it's mentioned a couple portraits, soft scarf. Hoping to get a battle damaged Wampa attack portrait in there. And he is riding atop our Tauntaun. Our Tauntaun is all resin, like the dewback we did before. They'll have two portraits, one that kicks to the left and one that looks a little more forward. And the horns are all interchangeable, so you can magnetically attach the horns if you want Han's version or Luke's, depending on which portrait you want to use. So everything's common to give some more display options to the customer.